So let's look at a concrete example where the hypothesis space is the set of intervals. So the inputs that we're trying to learn about are just single numbers on the real line. And the hypothesis space is the set of functions that return true for all the things that are between A and B, and this is parameterized by A and B. So how many different hypotheses are there in our class here?
At least two.
Sure. How about how many are there in the class?
There's an infinite number of them.
That's right. So this is one of these situations where it's going to be really helpful to apply the notion of VC dimension if we think we'd like to be able to learn from a finite set of data, which, you know, generally we like that. So how do we figure out what the VC dimension is? We want to know what is the largest set of inputs that we can label in all possible ways using hypotheses from H. All right, so I want you to figure that out. Figure out the size of the largest set that we can shatter, that we can label in all possible ways using these hypotheses, and then just, you know, write it as an integer in this box.
Cool.